same man whom you formed from the dust.
Which is a prayer in itself, invites us to reflect, to recognize and accept the gifts which we have received from God, and to be thankful for it, as fits the theme for today's day 7, Simpang Babi, gratitude to God for the wonders the Lord has done not only for Mary Most Holy, but also for our community and each one of us. My dear brothers and sisters in the Lord, through this Magnificat, we are encouraged to be like our Blessed Mother Mary, to recognize, to take cognizance of the many things which God has done for me. Mary is full of praise and thanksgiving for the many blessings from the Lord upon her, and her heart is full of joy. How about us? Are we grateful and full of praise of the Lord for all the blessings which He has bestowed upon us, or we are still asking for more and more? More blessings, more financial wealth, eager to make international trips now that the pandemic perhaps is slowing down a bit, but then we have only grown. Many of us have forgotten to give praise to the Lord for even being alive, perhaps still having a job, roof over our heads, and much more. We need to start to be thankful to God, particularly during these pandemic times, but at the same time consider how to help others, those who are in dire need of help, which comes in various forms. The time to think only of ourselves, or even the demand for more, need to stop. And in this season of Advent, to shift attention from my personal self to others who may be in greater need than me. Sisters and brothers in the Lord, we need to emulate the Magnificat of our Blessed Mother Mary, perhaps even to write our own personal Magnificat, to praise and thank the Lord, but also to lend a helping hand to those in need. I was searching for information on Simpang Babi Mass in preparing this homily, and I read that there is this belief: those who are able to complete all 9 Simpang Babi Masses will have their Christmas wish granted. Perhaps instead of wishing for our own wish to be granted this year around, we may want to consider asking the Lord to grant the wish of our neighbor who are in dire need, their wishes to come true. In this Eucharistic celebration, let us ask the Lord to grant us the grace of thanksgiving and the heart to help those in need, so that all may experience the love and compassion of the Lord and stand in praise and thanksgiving to the Lord. Meister Eckhart wrote, "If the only prayer we ever